Today on Upfront, Wisconsin's election for governor now just 17 months away. Who might be the Democratic candidate? And do Democrats stand any chance of winning back the state house? My guest today, State Democratic Party Chairman Mike Tate. Then Republican against Republican in the state Senate. Will there be a primary showdown in Wisconsin's 17th district? Representative Howard Markline on why he's challenging incumbent Dale Schultz. And Governor Walker testing the presidential waters in Iowa. Former Des Moines Register political reporter David Yepsen on how Wisconsin's governor might play with the folks next door.
Covering the issues important to Wisconsin. This is Upfront with Mike Gouchet.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to Upfront. In less than 2 weeks, state Democrats will be in the Republican stronghold of Oconomowoc, holding their annual convention, and they've got plenty to talk about, like how to win back at least some power at the state level. Party Chairman Mike Tate is running for re-election, and he joins us now on Upfront. Chairman Tate, it's good to have you back on the program.
Thanks for having me on.
Well, you've heard your critics. They say Republicans control everything in Madison. What has Mike Tate done to deserve re-election? What do you say?
Well, I think we've had some great successes in the last couple of years. Obviously, it's been one of the most difficult times to be chair of the Democratic Party, probably in Wisconsin political history. But when you look at coming off that recall election, electing Tammy Baldwin, the first woman from Wisconsin, the first openly gay U.S. senator, carrying Wisconsin convincingly for the president, and you look at the things the party has built, getting ready for 2014, I'm proud of what we've done, I'm aware of our challenges, and we are ready to keep moving forward.
Is the Baldwin victory and the Obama victory, are those the result of state Democratic Party efforts, or are they the result of the Obama organization's organizational skills?
Well, obviously, we worked hand-in-hand with the Obama campaign, but I'm proud to have Tammy Baldwin's strong support for my re-election campaign. I think that if you asked her and you asked the president's campaign, they'd say we had an awful big role in helping win those elections.
How do you win back at least some power in Madison? The assembly looks impossible, but the Senate, you believe you have a chance in 2014 to win back the Senate. Why do you believe that?
I think we are going to win back the Senate in 2014, and the reason I believe that is both because we're doing the early work now of organizing out in the communities. We've got staff on the ground all over the state. Getting ready for 2014, mobilizing volunteers, recruiting ward captains, but also because the Republicans are opening the door for us. They've basically given us the Dale Schultz seat, as well as we think they're going to continue.
Do you think you're just going to win if he doesn't run, or if he does run and faces a Republican opponent, you just think that falls the Democrats' way?
Well, it's a 59% Democratic seat, roughly, is about what the president got there. We are in the process of recruiting a phenomenal candidate to run. We think it's a Democratic seat, and that, Dale Schultz having a 98.7% voting record with the Republicans isn't Republican enough for them. We're going to let them have that family feud while we pick up that Senate seat. We think that Mike Ellis is extremely vulnerable, and we feel there's a number of other races on the board that are going to allow us to take back the Senate majority, even after this completely abusive of power gerrymandering.
So you don't think that the redistricting is something you can't overcome? You believe you can overcome that?
It makes it harder. There's no question about it. But that just means we have to work a little bit harder. And that's what we're going to do. And that's why I'm confident that with everything we're doing, with all that we're putting forward, that we're going to win in 2014.
Okay. You believe you have issues in 2014 in the governor's race. You believe the economy in Wisconsin is sluggish. You believe the state's premier job agency isn't working well. Well, you think the governor is more interested in being president than he is being governor. Mm-hmm. I get that, but who is your candidate? Who is going to come to the forefront and lead the Democratic Party?
Well, I think that's to be determined, but I think it's wrong to assume that us not having someone out there now is a sign of weakness. We think that it's the best move for the party right now. Scott
but
Walker.
You've got to raise money.
Well, absolutely, but we think that there is enough people around this country that are going to give $5, $10, $20 every time they're asked because they've seen this horrific Walker agenda and what it's done to Wisconsin, and really Wisconsin being the petri dish for the conservative movement trying to change a state around. Now, I think we're going to have a great candidate, maybe more than one great candidate. We're not going to have him until later this year. And that's because Scott Walker has never gotten anywhere without making his opponent and making himself the least worst choice. And we don't think sticking our head up early is a positive thing.
You need a private sector person to run against the governor to make the case on jobs.
We don't need someone from the private sector, but I do know there are a number of private sector people that are job creators that have amazing Wisconsin success stories to tell that I think would make very compelling candidates precisely because Scott Walker's record on jobs and the economy, which was his number one campaign promise in 2010, has been so abysmal.
Such as? Names?
Well, I'm not going to give you any names right now, Mike, but I can tell you that we've got several good people looking at it. We've also got several great elected officials in Wisconsin that I think are looking at it. And I am very confident we're going to have a phenomenal candidate to take on the governor and that we have a very strong shot at winning the election next year.
Which is more achievable, winning back the Senate or winning the governor's race?
Well, honestly, I think that Scott Walker's record is what's going to enable us to win back the Senate. And Scott Walker's record being what it is makes the governor's race in play. When you've gone from 11th in the nation to 44th in job creation, when we're dead last in short-term job growth, when the wages of the jobs that are being created are just abysmally behind and we're in last place in the Midwest on every economic indicator, and you ran on jobs and you've failed at it, I think that we have a huge opportunity to just simply present the facts to Wisconsin voters and say, you're not better off than you were 4 years ago under Scott Walker's leadership.
Do you have any regrets about throwing in with the recall effort of Scott Walker? I've heard some Democrats quietly say, that was a mistake. We should not have done that. We made Scott Walker stronger. Mm-hmm. What's your response to that?
Well, hindsight's always pretty clear, but it's not like it was ever a choice for us. The recall was something that was simply happening. The choice that the party faced was, do we want to try to join this effort and bring discipline, money, and try to win, or do we want to stand back and let this thundering herd stampede down the runway? We thought the best move for the party was to try to bring some order and discipline and resources to it, and I believe that was the right call. It was never a choice of do we or don't we recall the governor. That was always going to happen. It was simply a matter of what is our level of engagement, and I felt that the most responsible course for our party was to engage as strongly as we did.
I've got about 20 seconds left. Why Oconomowoc? You're going to go and have your convention in one of the most, if not the most, Republican counties in the state.
Well, it's the most Republican county in the state. It's also the third most Democratic county in the state, and it's symbolic of the fact we have a 72-county strategy we're employing to go into every corner of Wisconsin, talk about the Democratic Party, talk about our values, and talk about why we think we're going to win in 2014.
Mike Tate is the chairman of the Democratic Party. He's running for re-election. We appreciate you being on the upfront this week. Some Democratic leaders have expressed hope, as Mike Tate just did, that they'll take back the state Senate. It is a tall order, but could a clash of Republicans in southwestern Wisconsin help the Democrats' cause? And later, Governor Walker at a GOP dinner in Iowa. Why this is no ordinary Republican event. That's when Upfront continues.
Upfront with Mike Gouche, brought to you by American Transmission Company.